Welcome to Whatever Happened to Pizza at McDonald's, the investigative journalism program where I ask the question, whatever happened to the pizza at McDonald's? I'm your host, Brian Thompson. Before I was sidetracked last week by developments concerning the pizza McShaker fries in Singapore, I was in the process of investigating a disturbing phenomenon I discovered on the official McDonald's Facebook page. In what can only be described as yet another personal taunt directed at yours truly, aka me, McDonald's posted the following post, quote, "Remember when we served McPizza?" Unquote. Underneath this post, I discovered dozens of identical comments from commenters who wrote either the single word funny or the phrase ha ha ha. This despite the fact that McDonald's original post merits no such response, as it is not a joke, nor a jest, nor a josh, nor even a boner. Attempting to further study these deranged minds, I examined several of their Facebook profiles and found yet more eerie similarities. For one thing, all of them had the exact same number of Facebook friends, specifically, very few. Furthermore, they were all following the same group of Facebook pages, which are all entitled Abandoned Beauties. These pages post photographs of beautiful abandoned objects, most often buildings, in various states of decay. While it is true that there is a certain beauty inherent in buildings abandoned to time and crawling with lush green ivy, I also find something quite disturbing about them. For example, I cannot gaze upon an abandoned house without imagining the tragedy that must have befallen the family that once lived there. Perhaps they were forced out of their homes due to financial troubles. Maybe the patriarch was a family annihilator, and now the property is unpurchasable due to being haunted. Or, worse yet, what if the people who lived there had such terrible taste that no one ever wanted to buy the house again on account of how tacky they made it look? Sad stories, all of them. I find there is often a great sadness at the proverbial heart of beautiful things. For example, the famed Fabergé eggs may be wonderful sights to behold, but good luck using them for an omelet. Regardless, it was useful to know what kinds of Facebook pages these fascinating McDonald's commenters were into. To try and draw them closer to me, I created my own Abandoned Beauties Facebook page, primarily devoted to posting photographs of beautiful abandoned McDonald's restaurants and also of the abandoned McDonald's pizza oven lying in state on the desolate island of Adak, Alaska. It was my hope that some of my deranged quarry would be attracted to this page like moths to a Facebook page about flames. But in the days after its creation, I was discouraged to see that the people who followed the page were quite clearly listeners of this very program. I appreciated their attention, as I have certain emotional deficiencies that feed on it, but I was also concerned that they were not deranged enough to prove interesting to my research, despite the fact that many assumed the mannerisms of the deranged by posting comments such as funny and ha ha ha. But soon, the page started to receive quite a few interesting followers indeed. These began with several Facebook users whose names were written in the Cyrillic script of the Russian alphabet, which is very similar to the Latin alphabet, only it does not make any sense. Out of the dozens of commenters on McDonald's original pizza post, I do not recall seeing any bearing such Russian names. However, these new followers of my Abandoned Beauties page did share some things in common with those I sought. All of them had very few Facebook friends, and all of them followed at least one of the many other Abandoned Beauties pages on Facebook. Perhaps, I surmised, the appreciation of Abandoned Beauties originated in Russia, home of perhaps the most famous Abandoned Beauty of all, the Chernobyl nuclear plant. It makes sense that these people would not have commented on McDonald's post about pizza. McDonald's was recently forced to close all of its restaurants in Russia, so going to the McDonald's Facebook page likely causes the average Russian quite a bit of mournful distress. But clearly, their love of abandoned beauties spread across the globe, infecting those who would write funny or ha 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 on a post about McDonald's pizza. And it would only be a matter of time before I would find one. Specifically, it was a matter of 123 hours. As just over 5 days after creating my abandoned beauties page, I was notified that it was followed by one Christy Klinko, the same Christy Klinko I mentioned 2 weeks ago as one of the deranged McDonald's commenters in question. A handsome woman with flaxen hair the color of dressed flax, Ms. Klinko has 103 Facebook friends. She has no workplaces to show, no schools to show, and no relationship info to show. But among the Facebook pages she has liked is one called Football Live, which is about the lives of footballers, which Americans call soccerists. She also likes 4 television programs, Life Below Zero, HBO's Animals, the Discovery Channel in general, and The Simpsons. In addition to following several abandoned beauties pages, she also follows 3 pages devoted to the entertainment company 20th Century Studios, as well as a page called Animals, which is devoted to pictures of animals, and a page simply called Art, which bears a profile image that reads, "I Heart Art." On September 13th, Ms. Klinko posted an image of a sun setting over a tranquil beach. There is one comment below from someone named Horata Abara, who writes the single word, love, along with a photograph of a bouquet of red flowers bearing the slogan, "Good morning." Also, on September 13th, Ms. Klinko posted a photograph of a panther lapping water from what appears to be a puddle. Also on September 13th, she posted a video of a woman painting a painting of a horse by splattering paint onto a large canvas and then painting a horse on top. And on September 11th, Ms. Klinko meditated on that fateful day by posting several photographs of the cast of the upcoming 20th Century Studios blockbuster, Avatar: The Way of Water. While all of this gave me some insight into Ms. Klinko's deranged mind, for example, this is a woman who very much loves animals, art, and 20th Century Studios, it did not help me understand why she would comment, "funny," or "ha ha ha," on a post about McDonald's pizza. Here I faced something of a conundrum. It is a matter of some debate in journalism circles how close the journalist should get to their subject. One school of thought teaches that there should be quite a bit of distance indeed. For example, if my colleague Keith Olbermann interviewed Senator Mitch McConnell, he would likely consider it a breach of ethics to accept an invitation from Senator McConnell to go for a pleasurable outing such as a waddle massage. On the other hand, many people say my colleague Sarah Koenig, host of Serial, the first podcast, felt the best way to understand her subject, Mr. Adnan Syed, was to make him her boyfriend. But while this is only an offensive rumor, it is true that she entered into another kind of close relationship with him. She became his attorney. As my mouse pointer hovered over the friend request button on Ms. Christy Klinko's Facebook page, I found myself struggling to choose between these two equally reasonable, yet wholly opposite journalistic approaches. But then I sneezed, causing my finger to click my mouse. A short time later, Ms. Klinko accepted my request. My online relationship with Ms. Klinko quickly blossomed. I sent her messages asking more details about her life, her interest in McDonald's pizza, if she experienced any childhood injuries that rendered her prone to mistaking serious statements or questions as jokes, etc. I received no responses, but Facebook indicated to me that Ms. Klinko had indeed seen my messages. I was sure she was just shy and was working up the courage to allow me further access into her deranged mind. And I admit to feeling a certain thrill at the idea that this person while not responding to my messages, was at least seeing them. I imagined Miss Klinko sitting at her computer, smiling at the latest animal photo, art project, abandoned beauty, or 20th Century Studios motion picture release that came across her news feed, then startling a bit at the chime of an incoming message from me asking her something like if she remembers when McDonald's served pizza. In fact, I assume she smiled at most things, for she is clearly deranged. But over time, I began to wonder if this relationship was not doomed to be one-sided for its entire duration. Perhaps Miss Klinko was not working up the courage to reply to me, but was instead simply indulging her love of abandoned beauties by accepting my request and then abandoning our friendship. Was I destined to become the most beautiful abandoned beauty of all? Just before deciding that yes, I was in fact beautiful, I received my first direct correspondence from Miss Klinko. It was not a reply to any of my messages, which I admit had started to border on what some municipalities might define as almost tantamount to a bit of harassment. Instead, it was an invitation to like yet another Facebook page. This one devoted to the sea called the Mediterranean Sea. I happily accepted, not only because I was yet further thrilled to receive correspondence from Ms. Klinko, but also because the Mediterranean has always been one of my favorite seas. However, my thrill quickly transformed into a chill. For what I found on the Mediterranean Sea Facebook page terrified me to my very core. More details next week. And now, a word from our sponsor.
Hi, can I help you?
Yeah, what's a Mediterranean chicken sub?
Let me tell you.
It's roasted chicken breast, tangy feta cheese, crunchy cucumber, fresh veggies, Greek dressing, and fresh baked gourmet bread. It's the Mediterranean chicken breast sub.
You're gonna love it.
Opa! Subway. Eat fresh.
Hey!
Do you know what happened to pizza at McDonald's? Do you remember it? Please send all correspondence to pizzaatmcdonalds@gmail.com. Follow me on Twitter and Instagram @pizzaatmcd's. And purchase my best-selling book, How to Be an Investigative Journalist, at howtobeaninvestigativejournalist.com. To support the show, please visit my Patreon at patreon.com/pizzaatmcd's. For exclusive podcasts and other benefits. Thank you to my invaluable Patreon producers, Isabella Zeliskowski, Joe Kajic, Kimberly King, Kyle Turok, Pam Gabriel, Will, Andrew Duffy, Billy Jean, Brad Allen Thompson, Felix Dooley, Jay Poop, Calvin Thomas, Kat Resney, Laurel Paul, Mel, Opus Mareshi, Ridian Mistelli, Ryan Guggenmos, Sage W, Andrew Ahmed Johnson Rubin, Mitchell Kordick, Chief Keefe, Jacob Ford, David Friedman, and Marshall Deer. I'm Brian Thompson,